change.
Come on, Brother Roger.
Thank you, Chief. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
I'm glad to stand and testify.
see it. Y'all pray for me. Try to sing this song.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. It used to be when I was in
I'm morning, Scott. It's good to be here again tonight.
You, Lord.
We just had a wonderful time in the Lord. I tell you, God's really moving. And I appreciate Him for what He's doing, don't you?
Amen.
Praise God. We appreciate tonight all of our visitors coming and being with us tonight. Brother Brad Kennedy's church, we were down there last night. We had a wonderful time in the Lord. And we appreciate God. We appreciate them. So let's give them a great big hand clap. Praise God. Amen. I tell you, if you didn't get nothing tonight, you can't blame nobody but yourself. I really felt God here in a great and mighty way.
Thank you, Lord.
Praise God. You know, I believe tonight that we're going to experience even a greater move of God than what we have. I believe tonight there's dimensions in the spirit, that brother spirit, that we've never yet, amen, walked into, but I believe that we're going to, amen, walk into that. I know that there was a time that the Bible talked about how that this man waded out into the water that was so deep, and then the Bible said that they were waters that, amen, that just could not be swum across.
Amen.
So I know tonight, praise God, that there's deeper depths and more of God. You know what? If you hunger for more of God, then they got to be more of God to have.
Amen.
Praise God. And, you know, I was reading a book the other day, and this man, he was talking to his wife, and he asked her how much she loved him. And she explained to him how much she loved him. And he told her, he said that he explained his love to her this way. He said that he loved her so much that he just wanted to take her and pull her into him. And you may say, well, that sounds crazy, but that's the way the Bible says it is.
Yes, Lord. Amen.
And God will never be satisfied until we become one with him.
Amen.
How many know that's true?
Amen.
Today you can't get people, amen, to see that they are one with Christ.
Thank you, Lord.
Jesus said in that day, I shall be in you, you in me. As my Father in me. And the Bible said in one place, he said, for this cause he was not ashamed to call them brethren.
Amen.
God wants to become one with you tonight. Amen, church. And when we reach that place in God, amen, then we can see the exploits of God. How many believe that? Amen, church. You love Him tonight?
Thank you, Jesus.
Give Him another hand clap, will you?
Thank you, Lord.
Come on, give Him a great big cheer. St. Luke chapter 19 and verse 1. Statue. And he ran before it. for he was to pass that way. And when Jesus came to the place, he looked up and saw him and said to him, Zacchaeus, make haste and come down, for today I must abide at thy house. And he made haste and came down and received him joyfully. When they saw him, they all murmured, saying that he was going to be guest of the man that is a sinner. Zacchaeus stood and said unto the Lord, behold, Lord, the half of my goods I give to the poor. And if I have taken anything from any man by false accusation, I restore unto him fourfold. And Jesus said unto him, this day is salvation come to this house. For as much as he also is a son of Abraham, for the Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost. Amen. Give the Lord a cheer in your seat.
Thank you, Lord.
I want to preach to you tonight from verse 5. Where the Bible said that when Jesus came to the place, he looked up and saw him. Tonight on getting God's attention.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Look on your neighbor, will you, and tell him, say, you need to get God's attention. Amen, church. Praise God. You know, it ain't enough tonight that we need to just get the attention of God, but we need, amen, to get God's undivided attention. There's a difference in having somebody's attention and getting somebody's undivided attention.
Right, yeah, man.
When you really get somebody's undivided attention, it means, amen, that they don't have their eyes upon you. But they have their eyes set, amen, focusing solely upon you.
Amen.
And there's many of us, amen, here tonight, we need, amen, to do something to get God's attention.
Amen.
How many times have you ever heard that old message? their own rituals. They're satisfied, amen, with a bunch of traditions and things, amen, that ain't really focusing God's attention upon us, amen. But tonight, we need to get God's, amen, undivided attention. God ain't going to look upon just anything. He ain't going to move upon just anything.
Bless him, Lord.
He sought to see Jesus who he was. If the church don't get hungry for God and the desire to see a move of God, it's hard to go to the church, amen, and see the move of God whenever people, amen, don't desire to see it.
That's right. Bless you, Lord.
And churches today have become relaxed, amen, and they're satisfied with what they have, amen. But if we'll get a little closer and get up a little higher, amen, we can see more than we can get now, amen. Hear the attention tonight. He's meeting you in here tonight that you need.
Bless him, Lord.
To get his attention. We don't need God to look upon us.
Bless you, Lord.
I don't want God seeing me out of his peripheral vision.
Right.
Or just browsing over me. But I want to do something that will get God's undivided attention.
Yes.
Amen, church.
Amen.
There's a lot of churches today. That seem like you just can't see Jesus in your situation. Amen. The church, I believe tonight God has got a plan for you. I believe God's got a strategy for you. Amen. That you can draw the very attention, amen, of God and get God, amen, to give you his undivided attention. Don't you hate to get on the line and talk to somebody on the phone?
Yeah.
You try to talk with them. Hey, man, they say, wait a minute, I gotta be. Yeah. Hold. That's the way, hey, man, some of you, that's the way your God's doing you now. He's putting you on hold.
Bless you, Lord.
But brother, if you get God's real attention,
yeah,
and you go to God and say, God, this is important. Hey, man, I need to get your undivided attention. And when you get God's undivided attention, set his eyes, amen, solely upon you. And God's going to get concerned, amen, about you. Hey, some of you here tonight, amen, you need to get, amen, the attention of God. Amen, you need to do something, amen, to draw his undivided.
Yeah,
church. I hate talking to people, they say, hold.
Yeah.
You sitting there 5 minutes waiting on me to come back. I tell you what, when you get God's attention, something's going to happen.
Yes, it will.
And you know what it is today? We're not trying to get God's attention. Oh, we've been told, amen, just sit back and wait. Praise God, we've waited so long. Amen. Ain't you ever hear that old saying? Wait's what broke the wagon down. I'm tired of some.
The devil don't want me and you seeing Jesus here at the church.
Uh-huh. Amen.
What is it that's always?
Yeah.
There's always something trying to hinder us.
Yes, sir.
From getting God's attention. What was it Zacchaeus got down there? And the Bible said he sought to see Jesus who he was. You know what? That's an individual thing.
Uh-huh.
He wasn't concerned. Amen. About one old man, mother. He probably heard a whole lot of talk about Jesus.
Yeah.
And that's the problem today, Brother Johnny. Amen. People don't know Jesus the way they should.
Amen.
Amen, church.
Amen.
Praise God. All they hear some talk about.
Uh-huh.
They hear some rumors about him.
Hey man, don't get satisfied. Hey man, just a chill.
thank you, Lord.
Amen.
You can't be alone with God and have as the world burns, rotting turns on to him. But you can't.